there's a call now from the Biden administration, from Secretary of State Blinken, who has a very fancy resume. He is asking for UN experts on racism to visit the UN to combat racial injustice. This is a real thing. We need UN racism experts to tell us how racist America is.
It is such a cardinal flaw to even suggest that the United States is anything other than, if you look at the history of almost any nation in the world, I'm not sure you can point to any nation in the world that has a better record of race relations than the United States. I mean, we don't talk enough about this, Buck. I mean, first of all, this is a ridiculous idea, right? But the Olympics are going to be in Japan next week, right? It's impossible to become a Japanese citizen. It's almost impossible to become a Chinese citizen. You can cross the border if you're pregnant, and if you have a baby here, you're an American citizen. It doesn't matter what your race is, your ethnicity, your religion. The openness of America to people who look different and come from all over the world in terms of immigration is without parallel virtually anywhere in the history of the world. And this constant self-flagellation, let's be honest about what it is, that is designed to destroy America from the inner workings of all things, the UN, which is got all sorts of member states which are filled with rank racism and hypocrisy, like China, which is one of the most racist countries in the world. The idea that we're going to allow them to lecture us is just emblematic of this fetal position wimpiness that characterizes so much of the left wing in this country today. They're unwilling to stand up for American exceptionalism on any level.
Exceptionalism. They think that we're the opposite worst of exceptional. Yes. Yeah, whatever that is, that's how they view it. There are so many leftists who find it fashionable to trash America and have for a very, very long time. And this is why on the international stage you have leftists that will go along with, to the degree they can, any regime that is anti-U.S., and they'll ignore, for example, how many people even know that in a country like Cuba, there was long-standing slavery? Do you think that the Cuban regime sits around doing critical race theory studies in school? No, they're brainwashing kids, whoever is allowed to go to school, into communism. But when you look at the history of the world, when it comes to race relations, when it comes to where slavery has been practiced, slavery is still practiced today in some parts of the world, which often does not get talked about. I mean, if you go to some areas of, yes, the Muslim world, there is still something that is effectively the same thing as slavery. Go to parts of the Sudan, there are still slavery that is in practice. The UN lecturing us on anything is just too much to bear without at least saying what the heck is going on. That's where I am.
I am of the opinion, we talked about this, and it won't get discussed at all because of the 1619 Project and critical race theory and the idea that America is systemically racist, but only 4% of African slaves ended up in the United States. I know for many people out there listening, because of the centrality of the 1619 Project and the anti-American history, slavery obviously is a stain on the world as a whole, and it existed everywhere, but only 4% of the slaves that were brought from Africa during the during that era of slavery, and by the way, there was slavery everywhere, as Buck just mentioned, there was throughout the Crusades. I mean, the entire Roman Empire was founded on slavery. Everything in American history and world history involves in some way slavery. But only 4% of African slaves came here. And again, I keep hammering on this because I think it's significant from a historical perspective, Buck. The 1619 Project, we were colonies. If you're angry about slavery in America, most of your anger should be directed towards Great Britain, because Great Britain was who was in charge of American slavery for most of our history.
What about Portugal and Brazil? Look at all these. You want to see really awful, I mean, and when I say it's all awful, but the worst degree of awful colonial behavior. Look up King Leopold and the Congo region of Africa. He was Belgian, folks. I assure you, the Belgians aren't all walking around crying about how awful and he was. I mean, you got to read the stories. I can't even talk about it on the radio. Anyway,
he was the worst.
Go ahead, Clay.
He was the absolute worst.